Tonight on TV One Life.
All right, I'm falling. All right, cool.
We good?
All right. And we started at zero and went deep in.
Hi, my name's Matt. I'm here with my friends, and today, extreme tire diving. Woo!
Is this looking appropriate?
Stop! This is extremely safe stunts!
That's right, we've got nose plugs, ear plugs, a Navy dive SEAL team, and a lifeguard. And a floaty. Water wings. Woo!
A little bit dizzy. I was a little nervous at first, but it was worth it. I found a buddy.
And our expertise as Navy Dive SEAL members, we flipped the tire clockwise a quarter turn, allowed him to breathe successfully, and then we quickly assessed the situation and pulled him out of the tire.
The Navy SEAL dive team was pretty on top of it. I stuck my head in the air pocket that I had and just waited for him.
I think Josh is a really sweet guy, and he's crazy and bold.
She always agrees with you, no matter what.
My parents think that Nick is a mess.
Hey, I'm Sean here with the One Life crew. And we had a lot of fun this week. Things got a little out of control. You guys ready to check it out?
I'm ready.
Oh, yeah.
Let's go.
The students' assignment this week is to be blindfolded and have a stranger guide them. Their second assignment is to do a trust fall with people on the street.
What's up, guys? I'm stuck up here in a tree. I got a friend down there. He's gonna help me get out.
Help! Is there someone to help me? Help! Is there someone to help me?
Oh, I think you should jump.
All right.
All right. Lean down, like squat down.
I think the hardest thing about being in the tree was that I had to completely rely on everything the guy was telling me. I had no control.
All right, about how far do I got to go down?
You got about another 5 feet.
Just jump?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
That was quite possibly the scariest thing I have ever done.
Step down, straight down, straight down. Now your toe is on it, but your bottom of your foot's not.
Then you're going to step on it. All right. All right, now you're going to release down.
All right. I appreciate that, man.
Right. Now put your right foot on the ladder. You're going to have to, right now you're under the ladder.
Squat down. Turn around or?
Let me think. See if it's gonna be nice if you can sort of swing down a little bit, like slowly. Hold on, keep holding. I'm gonna lower you down a little bit.
Okay.
Okay.
I after I got down safely, I was much more willing to do it again.
Are we good?
All right.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, it was really scary.
How'd it feel with the guy coming down there and helping you out, getting down on a tree?
I was really nervous being 15 feet up in a tree and having to trust somebody.
15?
15 to 20, somewhere in there.
40 or 50 at least.
Maybe, I don't know, I was blindfolded. But it was really hard because I had just met him. I found him on the street, just asked him if he wanted to help out. So having to trust him when I couldn't see anything was difficult.
So what was it like trusting that guy, especially when he told you to take a step down and...
Well, I had seen the course before I went on it, and I knew that it was more than just a little step, and he was just making it sound like it was no big deal, and I don't know, I didn't trust him.
So what do you think, in your relationship with God, what do you think somebody can do to help them trust God more?
The more you go through, the more times you ask God for help and you see that he really can help you out, the easier it is to trust him. It's hard to trust anybody the first time you ask him for help, but once they've helped you continually, it's a lot easier.
So Josh, tell me, how can we learn to trust God more? You know, it's a process. There's a difference between trusting God a couple feet above a sidewalk versus being 20 feet up in a tree. How can we grow in that?
Well, I agree that there's big things we can trust God and there's little things that we can trust God with. And it's hard to trust him with the big things in our life if we're not even trusting him with the little things. You know, if he's giving you advice, telling you, you know, don't hang out with these people, don't go there, don't do that. We need to listen to that first before we can take his advice on bigger things.
I really agree with that. When I was getting ready to go on the mission trip to Ecuador, God told me to give $100. And so I still needed $550 to raise. And so I trusted him and I gave the $100. And within 3 days, I had received the rest of the money for my trip. And so now the next time that God asks me to give money to something, you know, big or small, it'll be a lot easier for me.
That's cool, man.
TV One Life, one hulk of a show!
Hello, my name is Dr. Susan. Please note that the sequences in this program have been performed by professionals, or at least those who deem themselves to be professionals. Do not attempt to reenact any said sequences at home. Engagement in such activities could lead to loss of limb, loss of life, or chronic rashes. Thank you, and remember to enjoy TV One Life responsibly.
Does your life smell? Then spruce it up with Internship. Internship is 1 year of travel, ministry, discipleship, world missions, challenges, motivation, transformation, adventure, and change. But wait, there's more. Internship is also TV, music, retreats, drama, events, prayer, friends, and incredible experiences that will launch you into your destiny. Don't you feel better now? Internship.
Bye, One Life.
3, 2, 1, take 2.
Hey, I'm here with Hulk Nelson, and we're on tour with him. And I wanted to ask you guys how the tour is going, what you thought about it.
Yeah. weird.
It was a lot of fun?
It's been awesome. This has been the best tour of 2007.
Sweet. This is a question a lot of people have been wanting to know. What one superhero power would you want to have? You can only have one.
You know, I don't know if this is actually like a superhero, but I'd like this. If I could just breathe while I was underwater, like I could just walk to the bottom of the ocean, I could start some new land down there. And sure enough, if I could have a superhero power, granted probably everybody else could have the superpowers. So like people would all be going down there, I'd meet like a couple of thousand people who would like to breathe underwater. And start like a whole little community and start selling real estate down there and building homes under the bottom of the ocean. You know?
That's neat.
I'd make some serious money off that. It'd be a good investment, I think.
So let's talk about in your relationship with God. Has there been times when you've had doubt in your relationship with him? Or?
Oh yeah, you know what? I've actually been going through some serious questions in my mind as of late, you know? Not real questions, but kind of like little doubts, you know? Like, I kind of feel like maybe this is just coincidence, you know? Like, I grew up in a Christian family, and I kind of went through the whole, like, you know, from the time I was 4 years old in like church, like 7 days a week in a church, you know, I knew the Bible front to back pretty much, you know, and, you know, I always knew about Jesus. I know I had them all in here, but I didn't have any here, you know?
Yeah.
And there's times where you go through things, you're like, you start questioning if it's even real because you've been fed so much of it and you don't really know, you're just kind of, you're just living because that's what your parents have taught you to do, you know? And there's a lot of Jesus in a lot of people's heads, but not enough in their hearts, I think. And that's something I'm just starting to discover. And like, just, you're always hearing little things, like especially when they go through school, like Christian school and stuff. I remember this time this one lady came up to me and she's like, man, it was a miracle. Like yesterday I was praying for a parking spot and there was no parking spots. And I drove around for 25 minutes and all of a sudden a guy pulled up a parking spot. I'm like, thank you, Jesus. It was a miracle. I'm like, no, the guy went to the drugstore. I picked up his stuff and left. I'm like, I don't think God, you know, and I always struggle with little things that people would always, and that would put a little dirt in my mind, you know, like what's coincidence and what's God, you know? And it's, There's the honest truth right there. I just said
laid it all out.
And that's just honest, you know.
Yeah. And I think, you know, that's really why it's called faith. Though.
Yeah, no, exactly.
Because if it's called reality, well, there's never any level of doubt.
No, you're totally right.
I guess, you know, in your walk with the Lord, haven't you found that, I mean, there's the degrees of faith and degrees of trusting God and you know, how does that maybe fluctuate in your life?
I don't know. I think, you know, life is always changing, and I remember periods in, like, when I was, like, a teenager where I would totally be mad at God because, you know, things going on, you know, divorce and things like that in the family. And now, like, you know, in your 20s, like, I feel like God's just blessed us so much that, I don't know, it's just, like, it's a lot of ups and downs throughout life, but, like, God is constant. He's always there. And I kind of just have to always focus and meditate on that He's always there through the good and the bad.
All right, it's time for our speed round. Put your hands on your buzzers. Question number one. Blank smells bad.
Ugly cats.
Excellent. You got it correct.
Really?
Number two. Buses make me...
sick. Seasick. Like nauseous. What is nauseous?
Number three. Who is the troublemaker in the bank?
Jason. Me.
Okay, number four. Who is the spiritual conscience?
Oh, gosh.
Jesus is the spiritual conscience.
Of the band.
Oh.
Holy Spirit. Literally.
Excellent. Number five.
Oh, gee, I wasn't reading the answers. Questions.
What flavor of ice cream best describes your band?
Pralines and cream. We're so nutty, you know? Just so nutty.
Okay, this is gonna be a great one. Number six, if you were stranded on an island, which member of the band would you eat first?
Tosti.
Aaron Tosti, the drummer.
He's kind of bigger, you know, he's got a lot more meat on him, you know.
He's just a big drummer, you know, just a lot of muscle.
True or false, do you regret doing this interview?
Oh, shoot. Yes.
False.
No, false. I don't understand. No.
Excellent. Well, we've enjoyed the time here with you guys with Hulk Nelson.
Come on.
All right, man. Check out their CDs in the store. Go online and check out more about them. And when they come to your town, definitely go to their show. It's worth it.
Hello. My name is Dr. Susan. The SAT prep word for today is rumptitis. 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 Now hit the books and get cracking.
If you guys enjoy watching this TV show, TV One Life, then you really want to bring one of these events to your city. We get into the presence of God, and we take everybody there with us.
You gotta be here!
It's it's really cool to see all those people come down front and answer the altar call. I just love going out there and sharing the love that Jesus has put on the inside of me with other people.
So I found a wall. Now I just need to find some people that I can trust.
Hey, Jesse, how's it going?
Hey, you guys want to help me out for a couple minutes?
Actually, yeah, right now.
Just us
two. You guys ready?
Oh,
no. Oh, who's done one? Raise your hand.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so you guys know what to do?
Yep.
And cross your arms. Alternate them. One. No, not like that. Straight out like this.
You got a square behind me?
Yep. We didn't leave yet. We didn't leave yet.
One. One more time. One. All right. How you guys feel about this? Anybody else want to fall real quick?
No.
It's a lot different than jumping off a high dive or something like that, because you cannot see where you're going.
You ready?
So.
Are you ready? Is everybody ready?
Ready.
Can I just crawl over?
Three. Really falling.
Oh, I'm definitely really falling. All right, I'm falling. All right, cool. I'm trusting you guys. This is a trust fall. You can
trust me.
The one thing that I really learned about trust is that at some point you have to make the decision to completely trust another person. That you have to let go of that control.
Oh! What happened?
You're a big guy.
Where are the muscles at? Come on. Oh yeah! There we go.
Will you do it, really? Awesome. All right, awesome.
It was really scary, actually. I felt better since I saw him catch you, but
okay.
It was scary.
Can you do it again?
I thought that was really cool how Melinda made the point that since she had seen me do it, you know, she knew that she could trust them to catch her also. And I know that in my life, when I see God do things for either me or other people, that it's easier to trust him more and more with the different situations that come along in my life.
So, Nick, you had a little bit of trouble.
Yes, I did.
Those guys look really strong. They're the big Incredible Hulk fellas.
I thought so too. When I saw them wearing the Hulk costumes, I was like, those guys got muscles built into them. They can definitely catch me.
That's how I felt when I wore the Hulk gloves. Not gonna lie.
But apparently looks can be deceiving.
So what did you think when you started going back and you didn't stop?
There was a second there where they kind of caught me, and I was like, yes, it was a success. And then I just kept going, and I was like, what's going on here? It kind of freaked me out, because there was nothing I could do to stop it. And I kind of just fell and hit the ground.
But don't you think that you know, people, a lot of times they look at like friends or family or maybe jobs or education, and they think, well, that's something I can really trust. And they get let down sometimes. Do you think that, you know, in this experience, you saw these guys you thought could really catch you, and then they end up dropping you? You know, don't you think there's some kind of correlation between the two of those?
I definitely think there is. I think that we can put our trust in wrong things a lot of time, and that things can be really deceiving to us, that they can look one way, but when we really see it for what it really is, it's nothing that we thought it was.
How do we know that God is someone that we can trust? If there's other things that look good that let us down, how do we know God won't drop us?
I don't necessarily know if I have the answer to that.
We can turn to his word. You know, the Bible says, trust in the Lord with all your heart. And so I think there's just plenty of scriptures like that, that if we really read the word of God, that it can be reassuring to us. That it says that over and over and over again, that if we trust in God, that he'll never let us down.
How do you know God's word is something that you can trust in?
Well, because it's never let me down. You might get to that understanding through trial and error by trying different things and finding out that they will let you down, but God's word has never let me down. So through the years, I've learned to trust in it, and I've learned that it works.
Welcome. Tonight we have with us Dr. Pepper from the Institute for Deeper Thought and the editor of the Real Reality magazine. Thanks for being with us tonight.
It's good to be here, wherever here might be.
New York, Doctor. We are in New York City.
Yes, I understand that, but never mind. You wouldn't understand.
Well, Doctor, I understand that you are a professed skeptic.
Yes.
You don't believe in Santa Claus or the Easter Bunny?
No, of course not.
What about God? You don't believe in God?
It's all the same, really.
So you probably don't believe we even landed on the moon?
Barry, anyone can fake a lunar landing. You take some rocks and you say they're from the moon. If I have some shells in my pocket, does that mean I've been to the beach? No.
True, but they do come from the beach.
You know what I mean.
I don't know what you mean. I think we have a caller. Barbara, go ahead. Are you there?
Hello, Barry. I just wanted to ask Dr. Pepper. I have a few dozen parking tickets, and I was wondering if they're real and if I should pay them or not.
All right, Doctor. Barbara likes this whole idea that reality doesn't exist. So tell her that she'll be able to keep on driving her non-existent vehicle and she will keep her non-existing license.
Okay, Barbara. The IRS said that I owed back taxes, but I don't believe in the IRS. I also don't believe that my name was Dr. Ruth. So I changed my name, and I haven't paid taxes since.
Doctor, I think you're going to be changing your name again real soon. Dr. Pepper, I've had a lot of really crazy guests on this show before say really crazy things, but I just can't believe what you were saying.
Yes. Perfect. Precisely, in fact. I think you're finally getting this.
You mean that you don't believe in something as simple as gravity?
Barry, if you need to believe in gravity, then you can believe in gravity.
Then, Doctor, explain this.
Explain what? I didn't see anything.
Well, folks, there you have it. That will conclude this non-existent show from my non-existent job, which I've poured my entire non-existent life into, if you're really even out there.
Picture yourself in a foreign country, changing lives. Come on!
My world now.
It's really amazing how God can pull stuff out of you that you never even knew was inside of you.
Describe this trip in one phrase, it'd definitely be life-changing, because when I go home, it's not gonna be the same anymore.
My world now!
Today we talked about doubt. You know, doubt can be a monster in our life. When we doubt, the Bible says that we're like the sea that's tossed here and there. He says we shouldn't expect that we'll receive anything from the Lord. Doubt in our life keeps us from doing the things that God expects and asks us to do. It's acting contrary to His Word. Doubting is kind of like this candle. If you reach out real slowly and you hesitate, you're going to get burned. But if you go real quickly, you can put it out. Let's try it. See? Didn't hurt. It's because I didn't hesitate. It's the same thing in our life when we doubt about the things that God wants us to do. Half of us says yes and half of us says no. We've got to follow God with all of our heart, trust Him completely, and then we'll walk the walk of faith that He has for us. I talked to this guy one time about what he was going to major in. He said, I'm going to minor in this, I'm going to minor in that, I'm going to major in this, and if that doesn't work out, I've got this to back me up and that to back me up. And he had all these safety nets built into his life. You see, God doesn't want us to live like that. He wants us to live completely, wholeheartedly for Him, find out what He's designed us to do, and to walk in faith in following Him and serving Him, not building a bunch of safety nets in our life. You know, if you want to trust God and not doubt any longer, the best thing that I can tell you to do is spend time with Him. Spend time in His Word. God is someone that you can trust. When we walk that walk of faith, we'll find ourselves to be blessed. Let's not doubt anymore. Let's trust Him with our whole life. About trusting God. You may have never trusted God with all of your life. The Bible says God loved the world so much that He gave His only Son, that whosoever believes in Him or trusts in Him, they'll have eternal life. Right there where you're at, ask God to save you. Repent of your sin. Ask Him to forgive you of your sin and be the Lord of your life. And you will be a brand new creature in Jesus. If you prayed that prayer right now, call that number on the bottom of your screen. Or go to tvonelife.com and let us know that you made Jesus Christ the Lord of your life today.
Your life dreams are shattered, but you're gone away. We've cried here for hours, and the hours turn to day. This, leaving us here with portraits and memories that we've held so dear. When I hear your name, it's not the same. No matter what they say, I'm not okay. And we started at zero, and went different ways. It's been 3 months since you left us, so far nothing's been the same. And my question without answer is, am I the one to blame? And he was such a good description of a favorite future man. He's for well of other people, and he said the same for him. When I hear your name, it's...
Hey, we had a great time on TV One Life. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you want to find out more, go to tvonelife.com. You can read their blogs, and maybe you can even email us.
Oh!
We'll see y'all here next week.